prayer. He told me to keep it short, but I have to tell you that I'm very excited for what you're going to hear. If you've never heard him play, you're in for a treat. I got married this past summer, and he was our wedding pianist, and it was one of my favorite parts of the day. It's okay to say that. We're really excited to hear him play. As is our custom and our tradition here at Indiana Wesleyan, we open our concerts and recitals with a word of prayer. So if you would stand as you're able and join me in a word of prayer. Father in heaven, we praise you and thank you for the opportunity to gather in this space to hear some incredible music by an incredible human. Thank you so much for Daniel, for his gifts that you have bestowed upon him. Thank you for his talent that he gives back to you, acknowledging fully that it is not his, but that it is yours. Thank you for his example in humility. Thank you for his example in work ethic and just a great attitude in music making. I pray that you will help us as listeners to be attentive and to be enthusiastic to the sounds that we hear and to be a responsive audience. I pray that you will calm any nerves that Daniel may have, help him to just focus on the music and focus on glorifying you through it. We give you all of the praise, thanks, and honor, for it is in your holy and precious name we pray. Amen. You may be seated.
Choosing to come here instead of outside playing in the snow, so I do appreciate that. So the first piece on the program is a music composition composed by the Baroque composer, J.S. Bach. And in this particular piece, it's titled a concerto. And what a concerto is it's a composition written for soloists or a group of soloists against a larger ensemble of musicians. And so basically what Bach is trying to depict here is two very opposing and different textures. You'll hear loud passages contrasting with the softer passages. You'll hear richer textures contrasting with the lighter textures. This piece is in three movements. We have the two outer, faster movements with the softer and slower movements in the middle.
Thank you.
song, originally by the Austrian composer Franz Schubert, and I actually had the privilege of working with Dr. Brodigam on a project a few years ago. And then after that project, actually this song became one of my all-time favorites. So this is originally for solo voice and piano, but then Franz Liszt, one of the phenomenal composer and pianist, transcribed it for solo piano.
Thank you.
composer of the next piece on the program, I'm sure you all know who he is, definitely still viewed by many as the Polish national hero, given his immense contribution to the world of piano music. The scherzo in its most original form typically denotes a very short piece that is humorous and witty, but then in the hands of Chopin, they become standalone, extensive pieces of several contrasting sections, which we'll definitely hear. So this is Scherzo number 2 by Frédéric Chopin.
Thank you.
say happy birthday to Beethoven, who would have turned 250 years old today, this year, actually. So there's been a lot of festivals and competitions dedicated to this very special year to Beethoven. And this is why I'd like to conclude tonight's program with one of his most difficult and celebrated sonatas, the Appassionata. And I think it's important for one to realize that in this particular moment in Beethoven's life, he realized that the deafness that he was experiencing was very, very severe. And you can just imagine the frustration for somebody who is a professional musician and having to deal with that. So once he realized that the deafness was definitely irreversible, you could really hear there are a lot of moments in this piece where he expresses his anger and frustration, particularly in the first third and the last third of this sonata. You'll hear a lot of abrupt changes of mood and dynamic, often very, very violently. And then the second movement, sandwiched in between the two faster movements, is very unusual in that it almost sounds like a prayer. It's almost as if one hears that for a moment in Beethoven's life, he looks up and he finds comfort and strength from above. So here is Beethoven's Appassionata Sonata, Opus 57.